For the purposes of this discussion, I'm gonna break it up into two parts. Number one, what sets it apart from all the other animes? And for this, I'm gonna be talking about Brotherhood, because Brotherhood follows the manga. I would say it's like the base Fullmetal Alchemist. Fullmetal Alchemist, the original series, that's gonna be the second part. I'm gonna talk about the differences between the two series. So, what sets it apart? What always hits me is over the course of the series, you watch these characters grow up. It's a coming of age story, I would say. You watch Ed at the beginning. He's sarcastic, he's funny, he's always going on about how short he is, he's mad about it, he's determined to get his body back. I mean, that's all the things that make for a funny series. Over the course of the series, you see him mature so much. He's making sacrifices for other people. He's protecting others. He's making all these friends. And small spoiler here, he gets taller. He gets taller at the beginning of the series. Winry is here. Ed is here. At the end, it's like this. He gets taller. He gets more muscular. And yes, I did notice that. He becomes an adult. And I don't know how much he actually ages in years. I know towards the end he's like 18 years old, maybe older. But his mental growth is so huge, and you can tell when you're watching it. And it's crazy if you go back from the last episode, go back to the first, and see how different he is. It blew my mind rewatching the series. You can see all the characters just interacting in these new ways and learning about themselves, learning about the world around them. And changing their own perspectives to suit it. I think where Fullmetal Alchemist really shines in its character development, because this series is built on its characters and it has this fantastic backdrop, it has this fully fleshed out world, but it doesn't rely on that, it relies on its characters and how they're interacting. Moving on to number two, it's long at 60 episodes, over 60 episodes, but there are no fillers. Most of the episodes have something to do with the plot. When you have a show like Fullmetal Alchemist that's long, but it's all plot, that's amazing. How much work did it take to put into that so that every single episode has something to do with the plot, has something to do with the characters? That's a lot of work. That's a lot of attention to detail. Number three, why Fullmetal Alchemist is set apart. It's subtle. For an anime show, it's very subtle. It has a lot of violence because this is a violent type situation with alchemy and humans being created that aren't really human and then dying again. It's a graphic sort of series, and yet it's subtle with its violence. When the violence isn't needed, it's not sort of used as a crutch. You have some series that that's their MO. Violence, violence, violence every episode. The gore is just unbelievably disgusting, and there's no reason for it. In Fullmetal Alchemist, everything has a reason. Another thing about it, this goes along with the subtleness. There are so many relationships, both family and I would say, I don't know, boyfriend-girlfriend relationships, that you can see without them needing to be explicit about it. You hardly see so much as a hug, let alone kissing and anything like that in Fullmetal Alchemist, and yet you know how strongly these people care about each other. What I'm saying with Fullmetal Alchemist, everything is there. They put a lot of work into the series, and you can tell it's so great. It's great. And for the first part, that's all I have to say about Fullmetal Alchemist. What sets it apart? The details. It's all in the details. Thanks for watching. Look out for part two.